I'm Adrian Patterson. Today on Upfront, the president's vaccine mandates.
We've been patient, but our patience is wearing thin.
We talked to former Lieutenant Governor Rebecca Kleefisch, who's going for governor.
This should be a patient doctor decision and not a decision that government makes for individuals.
And current Lieutenant Governor Mandela Barnes, who's stumping for a Senate seat.
But we need to be visionary. We need to be thinking about the future.
Plus, Milwaukee County Sheriff wants to set up at City Hall.
Taking on the issues important to Wisconsin. This is Upfront with your host, Adrian Patterson.
Hello, and thank you for joining us. There's no off season when it comes to Wisconsin politics. Just this last week, former Republican Lieutenant Governor Rebecca Kleefisch formally announced what we all already knew. She's running for governor. Meanwhile, the Wisconsin Senate race is among one of the most unpredictable and closely watched races of the 2022 midterm. Republican Senator Ron Johnson hasn't yet said whether he'll seek a third term. The Democrat, hoping to take his place in Washington, current Lieutenant Governor Mandela Barnes. The Badger State is certainly never boring. And we start today with the governor's race and our first guest, former Lieutenant Governor Republican Rebecca Kleefisch. Thanks for being with us today.
Thank you so much for having me.
So we want to jump right into some of the news that's going on right now. And President Biden saying that all businesses with 100 or more employees will have to require employees to get the vaccine or do weekly testing. What do you think about that for businesses in Wisconsin?
I think the government does not have the business telling people what should be done with their health care. We shouldn't have a mandate like that coming from government. These are decisions made between a patient and a doctor. Listen, I have a pre-existing condition. I had cancer. I've chosen with consulting health care professionals to get the vaccine. But what's a right choice for me is not a right choice for everybody. This should be a patient-doctor decision and not a decision that government makes for individuals.
Well, you're not being forced to get the vaccine. Because you could do the weekly testing, so why don't you agree with that then?
I think that the government stepping in between a doctor-patient relationship, whether it is Obamacare policy of the way back or whether it is the vaccine mandate, this is something that is preventing more people from jumping back into our workforce, which Wisconsin has a desperate problem with today, and making sure that the government is a nanny state. We just don't need it.
If you were the governor today, would you sue over this?
Absolutely.
I know you've been very critical in terms of what Governor Evers did, but I want to hear what you would have done, and not even necessarily now, but take us back to the beginning. What would you have done?
The first thing I would have done is consult the Wisconsin Emergency Management Plan, which is about this thick, and any governor knows that this is where you find responses to emergencies in the state of Wisconsin. And COVID was nothing, if not an emergency. All of a sudden, countrywide, we were dealing with a healthcare pandemic. And there are responses that we have already planned for, already built in, that encompass not just government, but also the private sector, so that all hands are on deck and involved in the response to an emergency. We saw none of that. Instead, we saw Tony Evers fail in his first step at leadership, where he threw a one-size-fits-all approach across the entire state of Wisconsin, shut down our economy, and in such chose winners and losers. And then, when inevitably tens of thousands of people were unemployed, couldn't even be bothered to pick up the phone for people who were desperate for unemployment insurance. And then beyond that, now that we are seeing a recovery and our small businesses across the state are hanging up help wanted signs and asking customers to please be patient, they don't have the workforce, Tony Evers was literally paying people to sit on the sidelines of our economy.
Would there have been a mask mandate under a Walker and Kleefisch administration?
I can't speak for Governor Walker. I can speak for candidate for Governor Rebecca Kleefisch, and no, there would have been no mandate. This is a choice between doctors and patients. It is not government's role. However,
a mask, doesn't that affect me?
I think this has been so highly politicized, and the spread of fear and shame across the board has been in itself shameful. This is a health care issue.
But doesn't your decision with your doctor affect other people?
I think all decisions can, if they choose, affect other people. But at the end of the day, it is your choice. If you want to get a vaccine, it is also your choice if you want to wear a mask.
When it comes to the 2020 election, do you believe that Joe Biden won Wisconsin?
I do.
And what do you want to see in terms of an investigation? Would you like to see the GOP, as some are saying, like Janelle Branchon, take over the voting machines and ballots?
I think we need to do whatever it takes in order to make sure that Wisconsinites do not feel disenfranchised. I have traveled the state up one side and down the other, held 50 listening sessions across Wisconsin, hearing from people who have felt very unheard, very unlistened to by government. And what they are saying is, we're uncomfortable. We feel like we might just walk away from the entire process and quit voting altogether. If that is the case, that is a bigger danger to our democracy than any amount of fraud. If people stop voting altogether because they no longer trust our electoral system in the state of Wisconsin, in the United States of America, those are scary times.
Well, the Republican Party is really fractured by this in terms of who wants to go in what direction with the investigation. Paul Farrell, the party chair, even told us that on this show. So what type of, I guess, investigation, I'm kind of looking for specifics here, do you want to see? Do you want to go the voting machine route? Do you, obviously, there's been a recount. Do you want another recount? Do you want people interviewed? What do you want?
Well, you know that I have declared my candidacy for governor of the great state of Wisconsin. That election happens in the future, in 2022. And so I want to focus on the future and my aspirational and forward-looking vision for Wisconsin. I
trust your election being safe?
I am concerned that people will not come out and vote in the 22 election, which is why I think we need to do whatever it takes to take a look at 2020 and make sure people feel secure and not disenfranchised, that people do get excited and turn out to the polls in 2022. But I know that there are people who are capable, who are doing those investigations right now. I think that they are capable of doing a full forensic audit. That is what I have been told that they are doing, and we need to get to the bottom of this. It's my job to present people with the vision for the future of the great state of Wisconsin. Tony Evers doesn't have it. He is a weak and incompetent leader. What we need instead is to get back to work and get back to school. We need to back the badge, and, you know, per our conversation earlier, we need to turn government back to the people.
Okay. Lieutenant Governor and candidate for now governor, thank you.
Thank you so much.
The former Lieutenant Governor was an anchor and reporter here at WISN 12 News from 1999 to 2004. According to the Wisconsin Elections Commission, as of Friday morning, there are two declared Republican candidates, Adam Fisher of Oak Creek and Jonathan Wickman of Franklin. More than a dozen candidates have filed paperwork with the WEC to start the process of running for governor. Democrats are hoping to pick up a seat in the U.S. Senate, and they're eyeing Wisconsin. We'll talk with Senate candidate and Lieutenant Governor Mandela Barnes. And still ahead in this week's show, Milwaukee County Sheriff looking to become Milwaukee's mayor.